Welcome to this video on Library and List Settings in SharePoint 2013. Here, we'll discuss several customization options, such as enabling or disabling folders, enabling or disabling quick edit, enabling or disabling ratings, and creating validation rules. These settings are the same for libraries and lists, so this video draws its examples from libraries because that's the more common use. Other library and list settings can be more complex, so NCDOT has created separate videos on columns, views, and versioning. Let's use a document library in the contributor work zone. When you create a library, contributors are allowed to create folders by default, and you'll see that there is one folder already in this library. If you go to the Files tab, you'll see that the New Folder command is available. As a designer, you know that using a file's properties, also known as metadata, is often a better way to organize and store your files. So you may choose to disable the Folders command. To do so, click the Library tab, Library Settings, and Advanced Settings. Scroll down to the Folders section and click No to disable the command. Click OK, then return to the document library. When you look at the Files tab again, the New Folder command is grayed out. Existing folders in the library are not affected. Use the same approach to enable the command. While this setting is also available for lists, NCDOT strongly discourages and does not support using folders in lists. In this same document library, let's look at Quick Edit, a feature which is on by default. Click the Library tab and Quick Edit, and you'll see a spreadsheet-style interface where you can modify the properties of many files at the same time. You cannot use Quick Edit to open and modify the file itself. You can only edit the file's properties. Exit Quick Edit by clicking Stop Editing This List. To disable the feature, click Library Settings and Advanced Settings. Scroll down to the Quick Edit section and click No. Click OK, then return to the document library. When you go to the Library tab again, Quick Edit is unavailable. Use the same approach to enable the feature. A popular social feature is to rate content. You can do this within SharePoint by configuring the rating settings. Before implementing this feature, it's important to note that a user must have at least contributor permissions to assign ratings. So this feature might be useful for team sites where everyone can upload documents, but there's no advantage to enabling it in a library if most users only have read permissions. In the same document library, click Library Settings and Rating Settings. Click Yes to enable ratings. We'll look at likes first. Click OK and return to the document library. You'll now see a column for number of likes. The user simply clicks the like hyperlink to rate the content favorably. Note that one document already had a like when we returned to the library. That's because ratings were enabled and later disabled for this library, but one rating was recorded during that time period. So, if you disable ratings, you do not lose that information. It's stored and available again when rating settings are re-enabled. Let's switch to the stars ratings. Click the Library tab, Library Settings, and Rating Settings. Switch to star ratings, click OK, and return to the document library. Now, there's a new column for rating, where the user can rate a document on a scale of 1 to 5 stars. The total number of ratings is also shown. And, as before, there's a previously rated document, which indicates that ratings had been enabled and disabled before. Validation settings let you test whether file properties contain reasonable values. For example, you might want to ensure that a document's due date is later than its assigned to date. we'll set up validation in the same document library. Click the Library tab, Library Settings, and Validation Settings. First, create a formula to check that the due date is later than the assigned to date. Enter the equal symbol to start the formula. Double-click Due to move that column into the formula box. Enter the greater than symbol and the equal symbol for greater than or equal to. And double-click Assigned to add that column to the formula. We also need to create a message to help the user if validation fails. Enter due date must occur on or after assignment date. Click Save and return to the document library. To test validation, edit the properties of the first document. Select an assigned date of today. Choose a due date a week before the assigned date and save. Because validation failed, you'll see the error message. If we change the due date to a week later than the assigned date, then save, the dates occur in the proper order and there is no error message. The key to validation is creating the correct formula. If you are familiar with Excel, you can often develop the formula there, then use it in SharePoint. The Microsoft Developer Network contains additional information on formulas. Go to MSDN and search for Calculated Field Formulas 2013, or use this direct URL. This video has reviewed the library and list settings that let you enable or disable folders, ratings, and quick edit. You've also seen how to set up validation in libraries and lists. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. Go to the main help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint Help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint Help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log in to Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC training group. Thanks for watching.